All right, so this is the lecture number 76 in our DSE series, and for now we are solving the problems related to 2D arrays. And in this video also we are going to see a very interesting problem of 2D arrays, and this is going to be the toughest problem of all the DSE series. Like whatever the problems we have covered so far, this would be the toughest problem in all of them. So I want a deep focus from your side for the entire video. So let us continue with that, what we are going to see today. Fine, so the problem is ring rotations. Ring rotate. What a ring rotate exactly is. So before this, I would request you to watch that videos. One is for rotate an array, how we used to rotate an array, and second one is reverse an array. So you should be able to know these two concepts before completing this video, because the complete solution of this particular problem depends only on these two variables, only on these two concepts. Fine. So I am assuming you have watched both of them videos. If not, then I would be putting down the link into the description box. You can check out from there, and then after watching those videos, you should come at here. Fine. So I'm starting from here and assuming that you know already both of the concepts. First one is rotate and second one is reverse, these two concepts. Fine. So let us see what is ring rotate. So let me draw a matrix first of all. Three, two, one, four, five. Is there any other boxes remaining? Fine. So this is the input which is being provided to you as a 2D matrix, and you would be asked to rotate this matrix by cell one. So what are cell? Let me explain that concept also. Let us say this is first cell. This is first shell. Fine. And this is second shell and suppose this is fourth shell and last one, this is fifth shell. Fine. So let me write also, this is shell one, this is shell two, this is shell 3 and this is shell 4. Fine. So you would be providing this matrix in the input, and along with that you would be providing a number called cell, let us say 3. Let us take an example of 3. So if it is like you have been provided this and you have been asked to rotate the cell of this matrix of third cell, or there would be another number would be as k, like at what time you have to rotate this cell, let us say it is 2. Fine. So rotate third cell 2 times. So what is the third cell? This one is the third shell. Fine. So I have to rotate this twice. So if you take an example of this, let us erase this. You already know this is first cell, this is second shell, and this is third and this is fourth. Fine. Or let us say this is third shell. So what we have to do, write down here 6 7 4 8 3 2 4 5 7 3. So these are the element in the third shell, and we do not have this element, this is the only shell. So what we have to do is we have to rotate it. Let us say we are starting from here, this is the starting point of any cell. So starting from here and ending point would be this. So we have to rotate this 2 times, let us say k is 2. So we have to rotate this. What is the meaning of rotation? Let us say first rotation of this. This would be coming here, this would be coming here, this would be coming here, this here, this here. Each element would be shifted by 1. So 6, 7, 8, 4, 5, 17, 2, 4. So this is the first rotation. What would be the second rotation? It would be each element will be shifted again twice. Sorry, once more. So 4, 6, 7, 8 4 5 17 2. सो दिस इज द के इज इक्वल टू टू रोटेशन फॉर थर्ड शेल. दिस इज थर्ड शेल. इफ यू आर कंफ्यूज विद दैट देन दिस इज थर्ड शेल. 7 6 4 8 3 2. 7 6 4 8 3 इज मिसिंग हियर बिकॉज दिस इज द फोर्थ शेल. 7 6 4 8 4 5 17 2. सो दिस एंड वी हैव टू रोटेट द शेल ट्वाइस. सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन विच वी हैव टू सॉल्व यूजिंग दिस टाइप ऑफ मैट्रिक्स एंड कंसिडरिंग द शेल्स. दीज आर द शेल्स वॉट यू हैव टू डू. सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन. आई जस्ट एक्सप्लेन वट इज द आई मीन एग्जैक्ट रिक्वायरमेंट फॉर द क्वेश्चन इज. सो यू हैव टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम एंड एज यूजल आई वॉन्ट यू टू ट्राई दिस प्रॉब्लम टू एटलीस्ट गिव इट अ ट्राई एट योर ओन सो दैट यू शुड बी अवेयर अबाउट सम सॉर्ट ऑफ कंसेप्ट दैट वुड बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू. लाइक आई ऑल्सो गिवन अ हिंट टू यू दैट रिवर्स एन एरे एंड रोटेट एन एरे would be the hint for this. Only these two concepts would be using in this particular problem. I know this is a big problem for rotating a ring. Let us say why we used to call this as a ring rotate, because this is a ring. I mean a ring, you can assume this is a ring and you have to rotate it, fine. So that is why we are calling it as a ring rotate, and this is the problem statement. You have to solve this for this input. Let us say k is 3 and cell is 3. Anything could be provided to you, you will have to solve, fine. So you can pause the video here and you can try at your own. And if you are done with your trial, then let us watch my solution, what I am going to do. Fine. So let us erase these. They are not required actually. They are required, but not, they are consuming a lot of space. That is why I am erasing it. So just give me a sec. Fine. So till now what we have seen, we would be providing this input and I am assuming that you have given a shot of try. So let us say we have been provided shell is equal to 2 and k is equal to also 2. We have to rotate second shell of 2 times. So what is the second shell? Let me draw now. So what could be? Let us take it. This is shell 1. This is shell 2. This is shell 3 and this is shell 4, fine. So we have to rotate this shell now, this shell, fine. So I want you to revise one concept of rotating an array. Let us say we have been provided an array 4 2 5 6 7 8 and we have to rotate this array twice for k is equal to 2. So what you used to do is I mean the like for rotation of this array we do have two approaches. We used to pick up these two element, last k element, and put them onto the front. That means the array was rotated. The second approach or and the optimized approach also was rotate this array, I mean from, let us say the indexes for these are 0 1 2 3 4 5. So rotate this part of array from 0 to k, yes, 0 to n minus k. N is what? Number of elements. Number of elements are 6. So 6 minus 2 which is 4. So is there any higher? Yes, so 6 element. So we have to rotate this array till n minus k. This is what? Minus 1. Let us consider n minus k minus 1. So 6 minus 2 minus 1 which is 3. So we have to rotate this array till here. Let us hide it. And we have to firstly rotate this array till here and rotate this span also of the array. So rotate this span and rotate this span. So after rotating it, what it would look like? It would look like 6 5 2 4, and after rotating it, it should look like 8 7. After these two rotation, rotate complete array. So what it would look like? 7 8 4 2 5 6. Compare this with this input. Is it not the same or the second rotation of this array? Yes, it is. Look at this. We have chosen last k element and put them into front, and this is the exact same. So that was the approach. We are going to use the same. So this was for rotation, and of course in the rotations we used to have the reverse logic. So this is how we used to have the reverse. So what we have to do, the logic is very simple. We just have to manage the things. How? Like the real challenge is to manage the things. Let us say you have been provided this 2D array and you have been asked to rotate the second shell k times. Let us say k is 2, fine. So pick up these element, or like pick up this shell and take all the elements of this particular shell into a 1D array ऑल द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द शेल, पिकअप ऑल द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ द कंप्लीट शेल इन टू ए 1D एरे एंड रिवर्स दैट 1D एरे. वॉट आई मीन इज, सो लेट अस से यू हैव बीन आस्क टू रोटेट द थर्ड सेल के टाइम्स और टू टाइम्स. सो वॉट यू विल डू, यू विल आई मीन मेक अ 1D एरे ऑफ द सेम साइज, द नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन साइड द सेल इज, एंड यू विल फिल अ 1D एरे. लेट अस फिल दैम. सो 7, 8, 4, 5, 17, 2, 4 and 6. So this way you have filled the 1D array from this shell. Then what you will do, you will rotate this array k times. Let us rotate this also. Let us say you are rotating this 2 times. So what would it would look like? So 4, 6, 7, 8, 4, 5, 17 and 2. So it should look like this. Fine. So once you have rotated this array, this is dash, which is rotation version of the 1D array which we have filled from this shell. Then fill all the values of this 1D array into the same shell. That means at the place of 7, fill 4, 4 at the place of 7, 6 at the place of 8, 7 at the place of 7, and 8 at the place of 5, 4 at the place of what? 17, 5 at the place of 2, 17 at the place of 4, 2 at the place of 6. So this would be your I would say the rotation version. So yes, so this would be your rotation. These numbers, the new numbers would be your rotation of the current cell. Fine. So this is what we have to do. This is the logic, and we have to convert this logic into the code. Like logic is going to be same. I will not be doing anything apart from this, the thing that I have explained. I will be using the same logic, but the thing is, we have to manage this. How we are able to manage? The only challenge is to manage all the things. Filling this array from this and make a 1D array and then reverse. I mean, put all the values reversely from this shell only. We have to manage all the things. Fine. So, what we have to do? Let us write some code for taking input and managing the output. Let us prepare a template at least. Fine. So, till now what we have done? We have taken the input from the user. And this is the row size, this is the column size, and we have declared an array of 2D size. And this way we are taking the row size into column size values from the user. And we have to take one more input called shell, which would be an integer. And we have to take one more input as k, which would tell us how many rotations we have to make. Fine. So this we have to do. So first step is to create a 1D array from the shell. Fine. If you look at here, I'm moving very slowly. I mean, this video is going to be lengthy, but this will make you understand very clearly, because you will have to invest some time if you want to learn something. So first step is you have to make a 1D array and fill that. So the initial, I mean, step from, or the previous step from making the 1D array would be, what would be the size for this 1D array? First of all, you have to calculate the size. Fine. So let us say I am declaring a method which would return a 1D array to us, int, let us say 1D, call it 1D, and or fill 1D array, let us name it that, and we will pass array and what cell. Is there anything we need to pass? I don't think so. We only need to pass cell and array. Fine. And let us say we have got our 1D array from this method, fill 1D array. Then what we have to do? We have to reverse this 1D array. So we will reverse this 1D array. Sorry, we do not have to reverse. We have to rotate this 1D array. Fine. So rotate 1D. Let us call it 1D. And we'll pass the 1D array. And we need to pass k also, like from where we have to rotate. Fine. So after rotating, what we have to do, we have to refill the cell or the 2D array from 1D. Refill 2D from 1D. Let us call it that, and pass 1D array and 2D array also. And yes, cell also we need to pass, and that's it. I think we do not have to pass anything. And at the last, we have to call a display method which would display the input, or let us display the here only. display here, we will not make any method for displaying. So this would be row size. I'm just preparing the template so that you should be having at least a little bit clarity over that. And I'm hiding this. And we have to make this as j is equal to 0, j less than column size, and j plus plus. And inside this, what we need to do? System dot out dot print arr of. We can also call arr as 2d array, but I'm leaving as it is. So print one space, and after printing each line we have to break the line. Let us see till now what we have done. We have not done anything, we just have defined the templates, and we are expecting this would print us or lead us to the exact solution. Let us see how. So if you look at here, first of all we have taken the input, nothing to worry about that. After that, what we have done? Fill 1d array. If you look at here in the first step, what we have done? Fill 1d array, and after that we have to rotate this array. So after filling the 1d array, we got our 1d array, we are rotating this 1d, look at here, using this function. And after rotating, we are just simply refilling the values inside the same shell, right? So you can see I am refilling 2d array from 1d using the same shell. I am passing the shell into this also. So this is done, and after that we are just displaying the input. So this is the high level thinking of the code, and let us move to the low level also, because you might be thinking that this is working, but this code is not working. But we are done with the template what we required. This is very important to understand. You like, this is the logic we just I explain you what we have to done. Now we just have to manage the things inside this. So first step would be fill 1d array. So I am defining this method. Let us name it as, of course we will have to name similar as we did our in main method. So static, and the return type would be for an array for this method, because we need to return 1d array from this also. And we need to reverse or receive 2d array and shell. Fine. So firstly we have to calculate the length. What would be the length for this 1d array? Length of 1d. So to calculate the length, we need to require one more concept. What is that? How many elements will be there inside this shell? If you look at here, for the second shell, how many elements we have? 16 elements we have for second shell. And for the third shell, count them. We have to count them. So for the third shell, we have 8 elements. No, we should have 9. 9. Okay, so we are missing this element now. That is why they are 8 elements, because we just have to cover the body. So 8 elements. So for second cell we have 16 elements, for third cell we have 8 elements, and of course for fourth cell we have only one element. Fine. So how they are 16? Let us analyze for second shell how they are 16. If you look at here, let us consider this wall and this wall. We will move wall wise. So 5. So how many elements are there for this wall? 5. So 5. If this wall contains 5 elements, then how many elements will contain this wall? Of course 5. So 5 plus 5. We have covered this wall and this wall. And how many elements this wall will contain? 5. So again 5 plus 5. And how many elements this wall will contain? 5. So plus 5. 20 elements. Fine. So I said to you that there are 16 elements, and we are getting 20 elements. So why? First of all, understand this. 5 here. So why they are 20? Let us analyze. If you remember the spiral display of just before that or two before that, this lecture, which was, if we are considering this wall 4, 3, 7, 4, 1, then we have to count the element from here, not here. Like, you have counted this 1 twice and this 9 twice, this 5 twice and this 4 twice. You have counted this 4 here, 4, 3, 7, 4, 1. And while counting this wall, bottom wall, you again counted this 1. So we'll have to, decrease this 1, this 1, this 1, this 5 and this 4. So we have to decrease 4 elements from this shell. So 20 minus 4, which is 16, which is nothing but this would be the logic for this. आई मीन कैलकुलेटिंग द साइज ऑफ वन डी एरे, लेट अस सी व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू राइट. सो साइज फॉर वन डी एरे वुड बी 2 इंटू लेफ्ट वॉल. हाउ मेनी एलिमेंट्स इन द लेफ्ट वॉल वी हैव, दिस इज ऑल्सो ए क्वेश्चन. सो वट इज योर लाइक फ्रॉम हेयर यू हैव टू स्टार्ट. लेट अस डोंट मैस विद थिंग्स. फाइन. सो फ्रॉम हेयर यू हैव टू स्टार्ट. दिस वुड बी योर स्टार्टिंग पॉइंट एंड दिस वुड बी योर, आई मीन दिस इज द मिनिमम पॉइंट, दिस इज द मैक्सिमम पॉइंट एंड यू हैव गिवन एस एस टू. फाइन. सो वट इज द लोकेशन फॉर दिस? इट इज द, आई मीन हेयर वुड बी, लेट अस से दिस इज 1,1. सो यू, बट यू हैव बीन प्रोवाइडेड 2. सो द कॉलम फॉर दिस इज, लेट अस से यू आर कैलकुलेटिंग द मिनिमम कॉलम. वट वुड बी द मिनिमम कॉलम? इट वुड बी 7s-1. एंड वट वुड बी द मिनिमम रो? इट वुड बी s-1 अगेन. वाई? बिकॉज यू आर, यू हैव टू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1,1. और सो हाउ वुड यू गेट 1? सो एस इज 2, 2-1 is 1 एंड 2-1 is 1 अगेन. एंड हाउ विल यू कैलकुलेट दिस मैक्स कॉलम एंड मैक्स रो? सो वट इज द मैक्सिमम लेंथ ऑफ दिस? ऑफकोर्स इट वॉज 6x6 साइज, यू कैन से नॉट 6, 7x7 साइज. फाइन. बिकॉज देर आर द लास्ट कॉलम एंड लास्ट रो इज 6 or 6 साइज, सो दैट इज वाई दे आर 6 साइज. सो मैक्सिमम कॉलम वुड बी 7 और द रो साइज, नॉट रो साइज, इट वुड बी कॉलम साइज, कॉलम साइज माइनस द सेल विच वी आर रोटेटिंग. And the row size would be, or the maximum row would be row size minus shell. Let us see for this. What is the column size for this? 7. 7 minus shell, 2. So 5. So we have to, this would be the maximum row and maximum column for this shell. So is it 5? 5? 5th column? Yes, it is 5th column. And is it 5th row? Let us see. Row is what? 7 minus 2. Again 5. So row would be 5,5. Right? So this way we will be able to calculate the maximum column and maximum row, and this way we will be able to calculate the minimum row and minimum column. So let us calculate them first. So int min row is equals to n s minus 1. I hope it is clear to you. If not, then you should watch what? The spiral display. Min column. Let us declare this way. And let us calculate max row also. I already told you that concept is clear, but we just have to manage the things. That is time consuming. So what is the row size? Row size is ARR of length. And this would be ARR, not 3Rs, 2Rs. So the spelling for length is wrong, length. And what would be the column size? Column size would be, and here we need to calculate the from S. So this is your maximum row and minimum row would be max column. So this is there, that was maximum row, and we have to calculate the max column. How? ARR of 0 dot length. This gives you the, I mean, column, maximum column of 2D array. Fine. If it is confusing to you about the 2D array, then you should watch my 2D array introduction video. I have made that, I mean, very deep discussion in that video. So this way we have calculated the minimum row and maximum row, and minimum column and maximum column. So what we have to do, how many elements in this wall, how we can calculate maximum row minus minimum row? Let us see. Maximum row minus minimum row, we'll see that also. So maximum row is 5 minus minimum row. Minimum row is what? 1. So 4 elements are there. You can count them 1, 2, 3, 4, not 4, plus 1 also, because if you, let us say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you have to count the element from here to here. So this is second position, this is fifth position. So 5 minus 2, what it would give you? It would give you 3, but there are 4 elements, you can see. So of course we will have to add 1 also. So that is why we have to add 1 also. So there are 4, I mean 5 elements here. And same goes for this also. How many elements for this? Like you will have to calculate the element for this and this wall, and for this wall also you will have to calculate. So how will you calculate maximum column minus minimum column plus 1? Let us see. Maximum column is what? 5 minus minimum column is 1 plus 1. So it will give you 5. And so you can count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fine. And after that we just have to decrease 4 elements from this. Because if it is confusing to you, then you can see while counting this element of this row, we are काउंटिंग वन ट्वाइस एंड दिस नाइन एंड फाइव एंड फोर ऑल्सो वी आर काउंटिंग दैम ट्वाइस. सो दैट इज वाई वी हैव टू डिक्रीज फोर एलिमेंट्स. वाई? बिकॉज देर आर फोर कॉर्नर्स इन ए सेल. सो लेट अस गेट रीड ऑफ दैट एंड लेट अस सी वट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर कैलकुलेट द लेंथ और द टोटल नंबर ऑफ एलिमेंट्स इन दिस. टू इंटू मैक्स रो माइनस मिन रो प्लस टू इंटू मैक्स कॉलम माइनस मिन कॉलम. दैट्स इट वी हैव टू डू. वी डू नॉट हैव टू डिक्रीज माइनस फोर ऑल्सो, बट लेट इज नॉट कन्फ्यूज, अदरवाइज इट इज गोइंग टू बी कन्फ्यूज. एक्चुअली वॉट आई वॉज डूइंग, आई वॉन्ट टू प्रूव दैट फॉर्मूला दैट वी डू नॉट हैव टू डिक्रीज, और लेट अस डिक्रीज दैट. नो नो वरीज ऑन दैट. सो लेट अस सी वेदर दिस इज गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड 16 और नॉट फॉर द सेकेंड शेल. सो कंसीडर दिस फॉर्मूला हियर. टू इंटू मैक्सिमम रो इज फाइव. ओके सो दिस शुड बी प्लस वन हेयर, प्लस वन शुड बी हेयर. मैक्सिमम रो माइनस मिनिमम रो इज वन प्लस वन प्लस टू इंटू मैक्सिमम कॉलम फाइव माइनस मिनिमम कॉलम वन प्लस वन माइनस फोर. सो लेट अस सी, टू इंटू फाइव इज टेन प्लस टू इंटू फाइव इज टेन माइनस फोर. सो इट इज गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू 16. दैट मीन्स आवर कोड इज करेक्ट. सो आई नो दिस इज कंज्यूमिंग मोर टाइम. आई कैन राइट द कोड वेरी फास्ट वे, बट दैट विल आई मीन आउट ऑफ योर माइंड. सो दैट इज वाई आई एम मूविंग अहेड वेरी स्लो. We just have to replace this minus 1 with plus 1. Fine. Now, if we got the length of the 1D array or the total number of element, then we can easily declare a 1D array. Fine. New int length 1D. Now, we have made our array. Now, what we have to do, we have to name it as 1D. And at the end, what we have to do, we have to return this 1D. But before returning, we have to fill all these values into the 1D array which we have just declared. So I am going to use the spiral display strategy, how we used to traverse over the walls. Let us say I have to fill all the elements of this wall. So for filling all the elements, what I would need to do, of course I would need to traverse on this wall. So how do we use to traverse on the walls? In the spiral display, I have done the deep discussion on that. So I am going to show you the code for spiral display. This is one. So where are all these codes? I have pushed all the codes on my GitHub repository. You can download or watch the code from there also. So this was the code for traversing over the rows and or the walls. So I can use the same, but what can do? Let us write the code again, or we can use writing code would be time consuming, but let us write the code in fast way because I have discussed everything in deep manner. You should watch that video, but I am again writing the code. Let us see what I am going to write. There will be total four walls only. Fine. So first of all, what we have to do, we have to traverse over left wall. So start from int I is equals to what? Minimum row. And if you look at here in the spiral display, what I have done the maximum column also. Sorry, minimum column. That will also work, but the efficient approach is to write minimum row here. So I will go till maximum row. I have done the deep discussion over there, maximum row and minimum row, why we need to traverse over the walls. So that concept is being used here. So you should watch that video. And I will make a counter also for filling the values. Let us say IDX, call initially it is 0, and we'll fill using 1D. I mean fill the 1D using IDX. So 1D of IDX, IDX of course it is initially 0. And what would be the value for here? We'll pick the value from ARR, row would be I and the column would be minimum column. Because if you see here, what we are doing, we are filling the 1D array from this. So the column is not changing here. Column is only minimum column, which is 1. Row is varying. So we are iterating over rows and we are not varying the columns. After printing the column, we have to increase the min C also. I'm not going to explain why I have increased this min C. You have to watch the spiral display video. And while filling this value, I will have to increase this IDX, because next time we have to fill the value onto the next index. Fine. So I will quickly write the code. Now we have to fill the bottom wall. Bottom wall start from min column and goes till max column and J++, and we'll use the same. Now column would be J and row would be max row. And after this we have to decrease the max row also. Again, I will not explain why I have done this, because this is time consuming and I don't want to waste the time of your also. Those who have watched the spiral display, that is also going to be time waste for them. So that is why I'm recommending you that you should watch the spiral display video before that. Now we have to fill the right wall. So for right wall, I have to again start from max row and need to go till minimum row this time, and I minus minus. And we'll again write the same thing. Column would be maximum column this time, and row would be I. Fine. And at the last, we have to decrease the max column also. Again, I will not explain why I'm decreasing max column. I will write another loop for j is equal to start from max c, j will go till min c, and j minus minus. So here what we have to do, we have to again fill this array, and column would be varying, which is j, and row would be fixed, which is minimum row. Fine. So this is the code for filling the 1D array, and after this we have to increase the, but we usually increase the minimum row, but here we do not need this, but let us increase it. But we don't need this, this is optional here, but in the spiral display it is must. Fine, optional. So this is the code for filling the 1D array. If you fill the 1D array, then what you are doing, you need to just rotate this array. So after, once you are done with this code, then where you will return, you will come here. You got the 1D array from the shell. Now you have to rotate this 1D array. Fine. So before rotating this, I'm writing the code refilling the 2D array, because this is the very similar for, I mean, to that. I am going to refill the 2D array from 1D. So let us see. I'm going to define one more function. Static what? It will not return anything. It will just rotate, I mean fill the 2D array and refill, and we'll receive the into this array also, and we'll receive 1D array also, and what? And in cell also we'll receive these things. Now what we have to do, we have to refill these values. So for refilling these values, of course we need this also, the minimum row and minimum column. Fine. So I'm going to reuse this logic from here, and we do not need the length of 1D because we have already array. We can calculate the length from array. So now what we have to do, look at very carefully. If we, let us say you got your rotated array 4 6 1 8 2 5 6 7, you have to put this 4 over here at this place. Let us say you are having 5, so you have to put this 5 over here at this index, which means min row and min column. So you have to firstly fill these 5 elements for this left wall, then remaining elements for this bottom wall, and then to the right wall, and then remaining element would be top wall. That means our code would be exact same what we have done here. This would be exact same, like we are fetching the values from those walls. Now we are refilling the values in the same walls. So of course the indexes and values are going to be same, except the values are just interchange in the rotation of the array. So I am going to use this same logic into this also. Let us see where are the changes. So IDX again would be start from zero, and if you look at here, by this we are filling the left wall. So left wall will start from minimum row and minimum column, and only this would be reversed. If you see here, in this row what we are doing, we are fetching the value from the shell, and in this row what we will doing, we will refill this 2D array from this 1D array. We just have to replace their positions. That's all we have to do. Fine. So let us write here also, and here also, and here also. And we need to remove this. So we need to write J and max row. एंड नीड टू रिमूव दिस कम्प्लीटली. सेम गोज फॉर दिस ऑल्सो, वी नीड टू रिप्लेस दिस विथ दिस. वॉट आई टोल्ड यू कंसेप्ट इज वेरी इजी, बस वॉट आई टोल्ड यू कंसेप्ट इज वेरी इजी, बट वी जस्ट नीड टू मैनेज द थिंग्स. सो दिस वे. नाउ वी आर डन विद आवर रिफिलिंग ऑल्सो. एंड वॉट आई एम डूइंग, आई कैन सिंपली रिटर्न द 2D array फ्रॉम हेयर ऑल्सो. एंड इट वॉज नॉट नीडेड, बट फॉर द कंसेप्ट ऑफ ऊप्स लेट अस रिटर्न. सो इट वुड रिटर्न द 2D array. फाइन. सो दिस इज द कोड फॉर रिफिलिंग द 1D array. द ओनली थिंग इज रिमेनिंग, रिफिल वॉट इट इज एक्सपेक्टिंग. लेट अस सी वॉट इज द एरर. 1D. ओके, सो वी हैव पास्ड द 1D array फर्स्ट. वी हैव टू रिप्लेस दियर positions. So 1D, and we need to remove it from here. Fine. So this is done, this is done. The only thing is remaining for rotating this 1D. So this is very simple. For rotating the 1D array, what we wish to do is, I'm just going to write the same logic for rotating. Let us say we have a method for static, and it will not return anything, it will just reverse the array. So rotate 1D, and it will receive the 1D array. 1D and will receive the K. So first of all, we have to manage the K. So still, I will highly recommend you that you should watch the video of rotating the 1D array. What we used to do, firstly, we used to reduce the K. Let us say if K is provided to you 100, but there are only 20 elements. So what you will do? Of course, you will reduce the 20. How you will going to reduce this 20? By taking the remainder of K by 1D length. That's it. And if K is in minus, then also you have to do some tweaks into that is K plus 1D length, or else don't do anything, take K as it is. Now what we have to do, we have to rotate this array. So I'm going to use the same logic of reversal, how we used to rotate the array using reverse. So we'll reverse, let us say you have 1D array like this, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And the indexes for this 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So let us say the K is 2. You have to rotate this array twice. So firstly, you will rotate this span and then this span and then complete array. So what would be the index for this? 0, comma, n is total number of elements minus K minus 1. K is 2. So let us say there are 7 elements. So 7 minus 2 minus 1, which is 4. So we have to rotate from 0 to 4. And then from n minus K, which is 5. To length. Fine. So this is the logic for that. If it is confusing to you, then I highly recommend you that you should watch the rotation of the array video, because that is the most optimized solution for the rotating an array. So we'll rotate the 1D, or we'll reverse this 1D from 0 to 1D length minus K minus 1. Fine. And we have to make 3 rotations, and the second rotation we have to make from length minus K minus 1D dot length till K. We have to reverse the array from K to length of the array. And at the last, we have to reverse the complete array. So this way. And here we have to mention minus 1 also. So this is done. We just have to write one more function for reverse an array. Of course, this is very simple, but still, if you don't know how we wish to reverse the array, then you should watch my what? Reverse an array video. I have done everything, and if you see, or if you are observing the content which I am providing you, I am providing you the content in linearized way. I am not like jumping from here to here. I am providing the content in the structured way. Firstly, I have covered the logic for reversing, then only I am going to complete the problem of like which problem consumes the reversing logic. Fine. So of course, I am not showing off myself. So this is the start point, this is the end point. While start is less or equals to n, we can write less than only, but just for the safety purpose. And temp is equals to arr of start. This is the just swapping logic. And arr of start would be arr of end. And arr of end would be what temp. This is not ARR, this is 1D actually. So replace it with that. Fine. So, is there anything remaining? 1D. Okay, so we have to receive this array as 1D. I know the video is too lengthy, but the concept is important. Fine. And what I will do, I will fast forward this video so that you can watch in short time. And at the end, we have to start by one and end by one and decrease the order. We have to start, I mean, plus one at the start and minus one at the end. So we are done with our code. And now I am expecting it should work as expected. Let us see whether this is going to work. This is the code which we have done. This code is lengthy, but the concept is really easy. The concept lies here. If you can see, concept only in these three lines. Fine. So let us provide the input first. So I'm going to use the same input which we have done on that. So this is the row size and column size. And let us provide the input. So 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 rows and 7 columns. Now let us say, and I'm providing cell also. Let us say I want to reverse this shell, the second shell. And sorry, I want to reverse the second shell and two times. This is S and this is K. Fine. So if I run it now, of course there will be some problems in that. Let us see whether there are problems or not. So I have hit the run, and the code is too lengthy. That is why I'm worrying whether this is working or not. Let us see. So we have to hide it somewhere. Array index of bound exception. So we have an exception in that. What is that? Array index out of bound exception 75, and 75 at the 75 line we have index out of bound exception. Let us see where we have. Okay, so I analyzed the code. Actually, we do have a mistake in that. That is after printing this wall or and this bottom wall, we have to decrease the maximum row. We have to like the maximum row was 5 here, so we have to move this row so that we can exclude this element and we can include these 4 elements. So for that, we have to decrease the maximum row. Here we were decreasing the minimum row, so we have to replace this R, sorry, maximum row, and we have to change this in while filling this also, because I have copy pasted the code. So that was the, I mean, disadvantage of copy paste. You have to look at it very carefully. So maximum row minus minus. Fine. So these are the two changes, and I don't think there is any change. Let us give it a run now. Now what we should expect in the output, we should expect the rotation, the second rotation. Let us see what we are getting. We were having this array. Like, why I'm taking this on the board? We have invested almost 1 hour on this problem, and of course, we should be able to verify whether this is correct or not. So let us take both of them. Fine. So let us see. We have rotated this shell 6554, the second shell, this one, and this is the rotation. We just have rotated the shell for k is equal to 2. So let us analyze. 6 5 5 6 4, where it is, it should be replaced twice, or it should move ahead two times. So 6 is starting from here, 6 5 5 6 4. Fine. Now this 5 6 7 8 9, 5 6 7 8 9, 1 9 2 3, 1 9 2 3, 4 5 4 5. That means our program is working perfectly. We have not done any mistake for now, and that is the logic for rotations. And there is a, I mean, a bug in this code, which is, let me explain you. If there is a condition in that, let us say we have to rotate this shell for let us say this is second, third, and let us call it this is the fourth shell. So what you will do is, here our minimum row is also this, and maximum row is also this, maximum column is also this, and maximum row is also this. Fine. So in this case, we do not have to like filling all these like 2D array and 1D array again again again. So if you can see here, we have only 1D array, so we just have to fill these values. We do not have 2D array like this. So we just have to fill these values and rotate, make a rotation in that, and then simply again refill from this row from the rotated version. So for that we do not have to do all these things, fill 1d array, fill 2d array, reverse. Of course we need reverse, but we do not need this refill and fill. We just have to take that row input in our 1d array and we are done with that. So for that I want you to try at your own. I can do this, but it will consume some time. There are only some tweaks or minor value changes, for that we will have to handle that, but I want you that you should try at least this problem. So I hope I was able to explain you the whole concept of this ring rotate, and I'm assuming if you still have any confusion in this, then you can comment down below. I would be replying there. And if you are continuing from beginning to here, then I'm sure that you are a consistent player over the programming. So still, if you have any doubt on that part, then you can comment down below. I would be replying there, or even you can connect with me over LinkedIn. We can discuss there also if you do have any question. But I hope there should not be any confusion, because I have explained everything in a deep manner, but still in that case. And so that's it for this particular video from my side, and we'll see you in the next one. Thank you.